हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज इंदिरा पाटोले, स्टूडेंट ऑफ बी इलेक्ट्रिकल सेकंड शिफ्ट. एंड टुडे आई वुड बी टॉकिंग ओवर द टॉपिक सुपर कंडक्टिंग मैग्नेटिक एनर्जी स्टोरेज टेक्नोलॉजी, दैट इज SMES, एज यू कैन सी ऑन द स्लाइड. सो दीज वुड बी द टॉपिक्स आई वुड बी कवरिंग इन द प्रेजेंटेशन: इंट्रोडक्शन, स्टोरेज नीड एंड इट्स टाइप, वॉट इज SMES, classification of SMES, how does it work, that is the principle of operation and the units at its feet for its work, and why SMES, why do we need to use this particular kind of system, and SMES, is it a truth or myth, and the references, that is from where did I take the reference for making the presentation. So storage, need and its types. What is the need for storage of energy? This particular kind of question has been used even during the guest lectures. So the answer is as simple as you all know. In electrical power system scenario, the supply and demand for energy does not really match. The generators that are designed to have equivalent capacity during, that is only during the peak hours, and hence they remain underutilized for the greater part of the day. So by developing a suitable storage system, the load on the generators can be leveled and the need for extra generation during peak hours can be eliminated or reduced by releasing the stored energy. As the energy generated other times is not necessarily utilized, so you can direct it to use as and when you need. That is all it has to say. That's why you need a storage system. Now, as you can see, the second point says the types of storage system. So these types were designed as per the need and the type of grid. Keeping in mind the commercial as well as the economical point of view. So these are the storage types, and pumped storage system, battery banks, which is electrochemical storage, inductive storage, capacitive storage, flywheel energy storage, which is in form of kinetic energy, the cryogenic energy storage, pumped thermal electricity storage, as you can see, and this is the comparison between the electrochemical, that is lead acid battery, mechanical, pump storage, flywheel storage, inductive, superconducting, magnetic storage energy. So energy storage systems. Now the space requirement, by we'll consider the first column first of all, that is the electrochemical storage lead acid batteries. The space requirement by this is low, the life cycle is less, for the lifetime, oh, for this I'm sorry, the lifetime for electrochemical lead acid batteries is less. The number of cycles it follows is limited. The cycle duration can be 1 or 2 hours to 3 hours. Efficiency is 50 to 90%. Cost is medium. Maximum power or energy produced by this kind of storage is low. Now if you go for mechanical storage type, pump storage and flywheel storage, so the space requirement by pump storage is high. By flywheel it is medium. Lifetime for pump storage is high, for flywheel it is also high. The number of cycles for pump storage is high, flywheel is high. Cycle duration is 1 or 4 hours to 24 hours. For flywheel it is 1 hour. Efficiency is 70 to 75%, and for flywheel it is 70 to 90%. Cost for pump storage is low, for flywheel it is obviously very high. Maximum power or energy produced by this kind of storage is from low to medium for both. Then if you consider the last column, that is for inductive storage, superconducting magnet energy storage systems. So these for this the space requirement is medium. Lifespan for such system is high. Number of cycles is unlimited. Cycle duration is 2 seconds to 24 hours. And you will see why does this happen in the following slides. That is, during its working, we'll discuss why does it have such kind of cycle durations. Then the efficiency is 85 to 95%. cost for this kind of system is high, and the maximum power or energy produced by it is also high. So if you conclude from the from this kind of comparative comparative table, you'll notice that the inductive and the capacitive kind of storage are the most energy efficient storages that have been developed, and these are always kept in mind, but the economical point of view is also considered. So what is SMES? Let's start with this introduction. SMES, the full form of SMES is superconducting magnetic energy storage technologies. It is becoming an enabling and emerging technology for power system application. As the demand for conventional energy, or say demand for energy, is increasing rapidly, which is directly increasing the greenhouse effect. So to manage our carbon footprint, the societies are driving towards development of EVs and alternative energy sources. This increased burden on power system, smart grid, can affect the stability and supply. The charging and discharging of EVs, especially the lithium-ion battery EVs, affects the grid significantly, as the voltage in the grid might decrease. Hence, to avoid such situation and to curtail to the rising demands, SMES acts as a power compensator, which can provide active and reactive power in a very short period of time. As you can see in the last, as you saw in the last slide, the cycle duration, it is 2 seconds to 24 hours. To understand this also, we'll go through the working. But because of this cycle duration, that is from 2 seconds to 24 hours, it is good. It provides active and reactive power. So this kind of system is considered widely. And where exactly, now the next slide says, where exactly do you locate the SMES system in the grid and its simulation? So first going to the model of EV charging station. As you can see in this system model, the SMES, which is with smart grid, is introduced to attached to is introduced by attaching it to the main grid, that is the AC bus. So this system model consists of a main grid, EV aggregation grid. That is, if you see here, it consists of a main grid, plant power, the SMES unit over here, the SMES unit, and the EV charging station. Okay, and synchronous generator over here. In the main grid, the synchronous generator feeds a bus line through the rectification unit. The SMES unit and the EV aggregation grid are connected to the main grid and at the generator terminal bus line. So over here, they are connected to this AC bus, that is all it means. And this is done so because the power flow at transient state can be regulated properly. The electrochemical energy storage have high energy density to reach the requirement of EVs application. Lithium-ion batteries, which are widely used in EVs, so to ensure their life, the charging state should be strictly controlled. Hence, to preserve the battery life over here, it is proposed to be 20% to 95%. Now, coming to the simulation, you see, that over here, this is the if you see the number of EVs, that is the number of electric vehicles we have to charge, which would be coming to the charging station to get charged. If it exceeds the maximum count, you arrange for EV charging. If it is not exceeding the maximum count during, that is considered during the designing of the EV charging station, then you again go to the starting point till the number rises to the expected point. Then if it has reached that maximum level, then you arrange for EV charging. You compute the voltage of the charger, that is the voltage has to be computed, or else it's of no use designing such a system. So it is part of designing process that what would be the voltage required for charging. And if the computed voltage of the charger is below the rated voltage, If it is below the rated voltage, you can see the it goes again to the SMES operation, and accordingly it either goes to the starting point again or it continues with the operation of charging the electric vehicle. So to analyze the impact of the overall EV charging in the distributed power grid, such as uncontrolled charging, off-peak charging, real-time electricity rate, and charging throughout the day are considered. Among this, the uncontrolled charging gives no incentive to the owner, so it is not being used, and it is only during the peak loads. So it is not considered widely. The battery life is important factor for as per customer's point of view. So hence, the battery lifetime depends on factors like the number. Of charging things like when the charging first assumptions are made. So the first assumption is like the charging state ranging from 20% to 80%. If the charging rate ranges in between 20% to 80%, the battery is operated only in the mode of charging, that is only to increase its life. The second assumption is only one battery is used to charge the EV to reflect the characteristic charging. Okay. So the next slide is about classification of SMES system. So over here, the general classification of SMES is as follows. Sorry. Very large and like large units essentially are meant for taking care of daily load variations. So the stored energy is in the order, you can see, of a few hundred megawatt hour, generally hundreds of gigajoules. So this huge amount of energy requires large superconducting coils of order of 1 kilometer diameter. Preferably, they should be embedded underground the rock structure, which as they are capable of taking huge mechanical stresses due to Lorentz forces. It may be noted that because of very high current density, the associated mechanical forces proportional to Li square are extremely high, and adequate precautions are to be taken to contain the coils against the large hoop stresses. Units are the second classification is medium and small size, which are capable of storing energy of 10 to 100 megajoules. So these units are useful for stabilizing the power system against the low frequency oscillations, and also to support a generating plant for a few seconds or minutes. In case one generator out of the several generators which are working for the plant fails, you can use the SMES unit. Then the third classification is of micro SMES, capable of storing 1 to 30 megajoules of energy. These can be used for supplying critical loads during voltage sags and total power interruptions lasting for only few seconds. When used as UPS, it is capable of supplying megawatt of power for durations of order of for few seconds. So typically a one kilowatt hour unit, that is 3.6 megajoules, can support 1.2 megawatt of load for 3 seconds. Okay, now we'll go. How does this whole system, when incorporated, how does it work? So the principle of operation of this system is that when the direct current voltage, that is the DC voltage, is applied across the terminals of the coil, energy will be stored. The current in the coil will continue to flow even after the voltage source has been removed. This is because when a superconductor is cooled less than its critical temperature, the coil attains a very less resistance, that is, it is negligible, due to which energy will be stored by the generated magnetic field due to its inherent current. The energy can be discharged by its discharging coil. SMEs can transist from full charge state to full discharge state at a very high speed and vice versa. So due to which the efficiency of SMEs unit is very high compared with the normal coils. Generally, the SMEs has very quick self-discharge because of its self-cooling via cryogenic liquid, which is present over there, the cryogenic refrigerator. Okay, so as we saw that the charging and discharging, the number of cycles and the time span required for it is from 2 seconds to some time. So that it happens because of the cryogenic refrigerator which is present over there. That's why the system is always considered, as it is very important for it to work as and when needed and in react in a shorter duration of time. Okay, so the as you can see, the general components in the SMES unit as shown in the figure consists of four parts. It has the low temperature or high temperature superconducting coil magnet, magnetic coil, the cryogenic refrigerator, the helium and nitrogen tank which is connected to it. You'll understand later why it is so. And the fourth unit is the control system for or the quench protection system. So first of all, we'll come to the low temperature and high temperature superconducting magnetic coil. Why do we need that coil? The whole system works for inductive storage. So for that, we need a coil and we need a magnet. So the magnetic coil, the coil which is used for the magnet is usually made of multi-filamentary niobium and titanium copper composites. For SMES application, cables with very thin, that is few micron diameter of NB and TI filaments enclosed in copper matrix are used for dynamic and cryostatic stabilizations. Further, it is very important that the conductor used in the SMES systems must have low AC losses. Smaller SMES, now over here, there are two kinds of configurations. So please listen properly over here. That is, the smaller SMES coils can be solenoid type and with flux densities in order of 1 to 5 Tesla. Whereas the larger units are made of several solenoids in the toroidal configuration. Now these two configurations are followed by to reduce the stray fields, which are for environmental reasons at the cost of increased length of the conductor for the same energy. And these leakage stray fields in solenoids are of primary concern to human health, aircraft navigation, and aviary migration. So again, there are the conductor which is selected over here. Again, there is a selection criteria for selecting it. So the major requirement: high operating density, self-protected at quench, ability to cyclic operation and multiple cool downs indefinitely without degradation, low AC losses. Now we'll come to the second unit, component, I mean, that is the refrigeration system. Now there will be a considerable amount of losses loss in the superconducting coil during charging and discharging, and continuous ohmic loss in the current leads that there are made up that as it is made up by copper. Due to these losses, heat is generated in the cryostat that will vaporize the liquid helium. So to maintain the level of liquid helium in the cryostat, there should be an external liquid helium plant for converting helium gas to liquid helium. This plant is continuously recycling the liquid helium in the cryostat. Okay, that's why we need the helium or nitrogen tank over there, as per whatever the liquid is, cryogenic liquid is present in the cryogenic refrigerator. For this refrigerator, as we saw earlier, is important for his self-discharge. Okay, so it has the self-discharge is rapid because of this cryogenic refrigerator, as we saw. So the working of this unit should be efficient. Control system and quench protection. The control system controls the transfer of energy from the power system or the grid to the superconducting coil and vice versa. It also monitors the excess voltage across the superconducting coil by controlling the rate of charging and discharging. All the measurement or safety devices such as thermometers, liquid helium level indicators, overpressure sensors of cryostat, Hall probes, etc. The control system should also monitor the possible quenching of the coil and initiate the necessary steps to safeguard the superconducting coil, cryostat, and the power electronic devices which are present. The whole thing is controlled by the fuzzy logic, which is embedded, which is burnt in the microprocessor for working of the whole SMES unit. And as well, this whole unit is connected to the mostly to a microgrid and the other renewable energy sources. This is so because as you saw, the operating cost as well as the investment is high for such for this unit. So that's why it is connected mostly to a microgrid and renewable energy. So in renewable energy sources, it is mostly connected only to the wind energy plants for now at least. But solar is in process. Now, why as such do we have to go for SMES systems? Now, the selection of a system is done properly, as you all know, only if you know the working for it and advantages, that is the pro advantages, the pro and disadvantages, that is the pros and cons of a system properly. Then only you can select the particular type of system. So the pros for SMES are like the lifespan of the system are high. It is highly efficient. Sorry, I forgot to type the G there. So it is highly efficient. The high customer satisfaction rate as charging and discharging, and the power, the voltage in the grid does not decrease suddenly. So that's why the SMES uses it. That's why the customer satisfaction rate is high. The stability of a grid is maintained without any hindrance. Now the cons, it is not mostly cost friendly. As you saw, there is high investment is needed, and even the maintenance cost is high. So second is the refrigeration unit is short-lived if proper maintenance is not provided. In all the system, if the maintenance which is needed for the system, especially the refrigeration unit, is not given to it, as it is, as you all saw, that the gaseous helium has to be converted to the liquid helium or the nitrogen, or you're using nitrogen gas, then the nitrogen has to be converted back to the liquid nitrogen, and for that the whole working of that cryogenic refrigeration unit has to be efficient. For that, maintenance is necessary. So again, that cost is going to be high, and after a certain period of time that liquid also has to be replaced. So again, investment is needed, and the system is small and mostly connected to microgrids and renewable energy sources for now because of its you also saw the investment is high, that's why. But yet developed countries are getting new projects in it, and they are trying to make larger units of this system. So SMES truth or myth? Now developed countries like US, Germany, France, China, and Japan have developed SMES units at small level. But at larger scales, they are working over it. And the US and Japan have this large unit of SMES in the grid. Developing countries like India and Bangladesh are working over its proposal and development in small stage, but it has started in India and Bangladesh. So the increasing demand for this overall thing has come because the increasing demand for power quality to several critical industries and increasing reliability in power systems are prompting for several developed countries to take up the development of SMES, while as well it is initiating us as well as motivating developing countries to take part in such an initiative. And so in India, the government has made it quite clear that it wants India to be a major market market for EVs, as you all know. So in future, however, we are very far behind in terms of creating proper charging infrastructure for electric vehicles. Keeping this in mind, the government has recently approved 10,000 crore rupees of budget for FAME. Now, what is FAME? FAME is a scheme, faster adoption and manufacturing of hybrid and electric vehicles in India. So the following table, the following slide conveys a table to you all, which is a possible scenario for SMEs in future in India. So it was created by BHEL, that is BHEL, and IIT Kharagpur. So please go through this table as it is quite big. It wouldn't be of much help if I read it to you all right now, but please go through it. You all will understand the classification we went through. So the different kinds of SMEs units, medium SMEs units, large SMEs units, the whole scaling, the installation location, the effect it has on the grid and the electric vehicles. So please go through it. You all will understand. The effect of higher operating temperature on a 5000 megawatt hour plant is to increase the overall efficiency by reducing the cryogenic losses and to reduce the cost of the plant. So this was a table, and it consists of the operating temperature, the efficiency, and the cost of the whole plant when we use such different kinds of different chemicals in the as a cryogenic liquid. So please go through that as well, and the efficiency as well differs. So accordingly, keeping in mind the again the economical point of view, we select the cryogenic liquid, but always the best what is needed is chosen. So these were the sites from where I took the reference. As in when you all need, if you all need the papers for reference for studying and all, please do ask, do text. I'll forward you all the papers as well as the presentation. And if you all have any questions, again, do ping me. I'll try to answer, but I'll surely give you all the papers, IEEE papers. I tried to go through and understand. So even you all will understand if you all have any doubts, okay? So thank you.